basically we have two raw materials. We have silicon dioxide, in this case in the form of quartzite, which we mine at our mine up in Moora, about 400 kilometres to the north, and a source of carbon, which is known as a reductant. So what the reductant does is it is a source of carbon. The silicon dioxide is silicon with two oxygens hanging off it. And what the carbon does is when we add a lot of energy to this process in a furnace, the carbon will essentially strip off the oxygens off the silicon dioxide and leave us with the elemental silicon metal, which is remarkably different looking product, but essentially has a lot of the same sort of properties as quartz, in such as it can be crushed, ground, much like a rock. The ambient temperature in the summertime, just in the furnaces, it can get up to 60 degrees in there. The process is several thousand degrees. So obviously we need to put a lot of energy into this process because the bond between the oxygen and the silicon is extremely strong, and the only way that it can get broken is the input of a lot of energy. We basically have the crucible of the furnace, and the crucible of the furnace has several tap holes around the bottom of the furnace. What we do is we open up one of those tap holes, which allows the metal to flow out of the furnace, out of the reaction zone, and we collect that in a large ladle, which is essentially just a large teapot that we can pick up, collect the metal, and we pour that out into our chill frames. The guy down on the pour room, he's tipping the silicon into what's called a chill frame. So we're turning the molten silicon into a solid brick of silicon. So very simple process. He's pouring that out into a mold. As the pour's going on, he takes several samples of the molten silicon. The molten silicon is then analysed in our lab, and we can make sure it fits our customer's specifications. Our control room controls the whole operation. It has a lot of automation. We have a lot of remote sensing around the plant to ensure that everything's running at peak efficiencies, and we're making sure that our mix of raw materials is pretty much weighed precisely down to the kilogram. The downstream uses of this are many and varied. The most visual aspect is these are used to create photovoltaic solar cells. They're obviously a large part of reducing our global emissions and our dependence on fossil fuels, but they're also used in a variety of other uses. Semiconductors are pretty much are in any single electronic device that we use these days, computers, mobile phones, televisions. So yeah, life would be a lot different if we didn't have silicon.